Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about different types of PCR. Now what is a PCR? PCR is a polymerase chain reaction. It is a molecular technology aimed to amplify single or few copies of DNA into thousands or millions of copies. It was developed by Carey Mullis in the year 1983. PCR is now a common and often indispensable technique used in medical and biological research laboratory for variety of application. These include diagnosis of infectious diseases, DNA sequencing, DNA-based phylogeny. In 1993, Mullis was awarded Nobel Prize in chemistry along with Michael Smith for his work on PCR. Now, what are the different types of PCR? Different types of PCR are conventional PCR, which is a qualitative PCR, multiplex, nested, RT-PCR or QTR PCR, quantitative PCR, hot star PCR, touchdown PCR, assembly PCR, colony PCR, methylation specific PCR and LAMP assay. Now what are the chemicals which are required for the PCR reaction? First is the magnesium chloride, which is ranging from 0.5 to 2.5 millimolar, buffer with a pH ranging from 8.3 to 8.8. DNTPs, these are important. DNTPs which range from 20 to 200 micromolar. Primer which range from 0.1 to 0.5 micromolar. DNA polymerase, which helps in amplification of the DNA, where it is required like 1 to 2.5 unit. Target DNA should be approximately 1 microgram. Now usually the PCR cycle consists of three main steps. One is denaturation, second is the annealing, and third one is the extension. Now what are the basic requirement for PCR reaction? First is the DNA sequence of target region must be known, and primer typically 20 to 30 base pair in size. This can be readily produced by commercial companies, can also be prepared using DNA synthesizer. Thermostable DNA polymerase example is stack polymerase, which is not inactivated by heating at 95 degrees centigrade. Remember the temperature for extension or the temperature for denaturation is 95 degrees centigrade. So at this temperature, the DNA polymerase should not get inactivated, so we use stack polymerase. Then DNA thermal cycler, a machine which can be programmed to carry out heating and cooling of the sample over number of cycle. Now I'm going to explain the three important steps which are present in the PCR reaction. First step is the denaturation. In denaturation step, the double-stranded DNA will be melted down into a single-stranded DNA at a temperature of 94 degrees centigrade for 1 minute. In the second step, it is called as annealing, where the temperature ranges from 50 to 70 degrees centigrade depending on the melting temperature of the expected duplex. The primer at this temperature, it could be like 45 seconds also. At this temperature, both forward as well as the reverse primer will go and bind to the complementary sequence of the DNA, that is the single-stranded DNA. So first was the denaturation, where it is for 1 minute at a temperature of 94 degree, whereas in case of annealing later, the second step is the annealing, in which the single-stranded DNA to the single-stranded DNA, the primer will bind at a temperature of around like 50 to 70 degree. The range varies according to the sample. So for 45 seconds, that primer is going to, the complementary primer will go and bind to the single-stranded DNA. After that, the third step is the extension, in which The temperature will be at 72 degrees centigrade for 2 minutes, and here and the time might vary from 0.5 to 3 minutes. In this temperature, the DNA polymerase go and binds to the annealed primer and extend the DNA at 3 prime end of the chain, so that it will start adding up all the dNTP which has been added to the reaction mixture. In this way, DNA will be amplified within this time of period. So the DNA start multiplying with this temperature at this programmed time, and every time the cycle will finish, there will be a like this reaction will finish within this time period, and the amplification number also will start and end within the programmed set. Now, one such example for PCR program is this one, where the initial denaturation will be for 95 degree for 5 minutes, whereas a thermocycle file will be for 30 cycles, denaturation at 95 degrees centigrade for 30 second, annealing for 55 degrees centigrade for 30 second, extension for 72 degrees centigrade for 45 second, whereas the final extension will be for 72 degrees centigrade for 5 minutes. Now, what are the application of PCR? It is applied in molecular identification, sequencing, and genetic engineering. In case of molecular identification, it has been used for molecular archaeology, molecular epidemiology, molecular ecology, DNA fingerprinting, classification of organism, genotyping, prenatal diagnosis, mutation screening, drug discovery, and genetic matching. Sequencing could be bioinformatics, sequencing in the field of bioinformatics, genomic cloning, human genome project. Genetic engineering, in case of genetic engineering, it is used in case of site-directed mutagenesis, gene expression studies. Quantitative PCR or qPCR. It is used to measure the quantity of PCR product, commonly a real time. It quantitatively measures starting amount of DNA, cDNA or RNA. qPCR is commonly used to determine whether the DNA sequence is present in a sample and the number of its copy in the sample. Quantitative real-time PCR has a very high degree of precision. QRT PCR method use fluorescent dye such as cybergreen, Eva green, and fluorophore containing DNA probe such as Tacman to measure the amount of amplified product in real time. There are two types of marker, one is Tacman probe and cybergreen. In case of Tacman probe, it consists, this is a hydrolysis probe, it bears a reporter dye, often fluorescent at its 5 prime end, and a quencher which is a tetramethyl rhodamine attached to the 3 prime end of oligonucleotide. In normal condition, the probe remain coiled onto itself, bring the fluorescence signal, a fluorescence dye near the quencher, causing quenching of fluorescent signal of the dye. The oligonucleotide of the Tacman polymerase has homologous region with the target gene. When the target sequence is present in the mixture, it binds with the sample DNA. As Tac polymerase starts to replicate the new DNA strand at extension stage, it causes degradation of the 5 prime end. Degradation of the probe by 5 prime end nuclease activity, and the fluorescein is get separated from the quencher and fluorescein signal is generated. As this procedure continue at each cycle, the number of signal molecule increase, causing the increase of signal, which is positively related to the amplification of the DNA. Cybergreen, this is a dye that provide prominent fluorescent signal when it binds to the minor groove of DNA non-specifically. Other fluorescent dye like ethylene bromide or acridine orange can also be used, but cybergreen is better used for its higher signal intensity. Cybergreen is better than Tachman probe as it can provide the information about each cycle as well as about the melting temperature that is not obtained by the Tachman probe, but it suffers for the disadvantage of no specificity, which is assured by Tachman probe. So cybergreen can suffer from a signaling for unexpected DNA materials. The progress of DNA amplification during the real time by measuring the release of fluorescent flash during the amplification. The computer measures the rate of flash, rate of flashing in 96 simultaneous experimental PCR reaction relative to the control reaction. Now, what are the applications of quantitative PCR? It is used to measure specific amount of target DNA or RNA in sample. It by measuring the amplification only within the phase of true exponential increase, the amount of measured product more accurately reflect the initial amount of the target. Special thermal cyclers are used that monitor the amount of the product during the amplification. Reverse transcription PCR or RT-PCR. It is a PCR designed for amplifying the DNA from RNA. Reverse transcriptase reverse transcribe the RNA into cDNA, which is then amplified by PCR. RT-PCR is widely used in expression profiling to determine the expression of the gene or to identify the sequence of the RNA transcript, including transcription start and termination. If the genomic DNA sequence of a gene is known, RT-PCR can be used to map the location of exon and intron in the gene. The 5' end of the gene corresponds to the transcript start site is typically identified by rapid amplification of cDNA ends. There are two types of RT-PCR. One is one-step RT-PCR, another one is a two-step RT-PCR. In case of one-step RT-PCR, all the reaction components are mixed in one tube prior to initiation of the reaction. Now, the components are RNA, primer, reverse transcriptase, DNA polymerase, and buffer reagent. So, in case of one-step RT-PCR, offer a simplicity and convenient and minimize the possibility of contamination. The resulting cDNA cannot be used for the detecting multiple messages from a single RNA sample as in two-step RT-PCR. Whereas in case of two-step RT-PCR, it is a traditional type which involves two steps, that is one RT reaction and a PCR amplification, that is reverse transcription reaction and a PCR amplification. Here first the RNA is first reverse transcribed into complementary DNA using enzyme reverse transcriptase. The resulting cDNA is used as a template for subsequent PCR amplification using primer specific to one or more genes. So that's why it consists of a two step. One is the cDNA preparation, and by using this cDNA, PCR amplification will be done. So that's why it has a two step RT-PCR principles. Application of RT-PCR. The exponential amplification of reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction provide a high sensitive technique in which a very low copy number of RNA molecule can be detected. RT-PCR is widely used in diagnosis of genetic diseases and semi-quantitatively in the determination of abundance of specific different RNA molecule within a cell or tissue as measured in as measure of gene expression. In case of a research method qRT-PCR is used to measure the expression of Gal gene in yeast cells. Gene insertion. RT-PCR can also be very useful in the insertion of eukaryotic gene in prokaryotes. Into the prokaryotes, RT-PCR is commonly used in studying the genome of virus whose genome are compared, whose genome are composed of RNA such as influenza virus A and retrovirus like HIV. Genetic diseases diagnosis. RT-PCR can be used to diagnose genetic diseases such as bird flu, H7N9, cancer detection. Scientists are working on ways to use RT-PCR in cancer detection to help improve the diagnosis and monitor response to therapy. Multiplex RT-PCR. It is a special type of PCR used for the detection of multiple pathogen by using multiple primer set, each one target a particular pathogen. Uses it permits simultaneous analysis of multiple target in single sample. Nested PCR. It is used to increase the specificity of the DNA amplification. Here, two set of primers are used in two successive reactions. In the first PCR, one pair of primers is used to generate a DNA product which will be targeted for second reaction. Using one or two different primers whose binding site are located. Now, the binding site which is located is called nested within the first set, thus increasing the specificity. So it will be used for pathogen that occur in very few amount. Next is hot star PCR. It is a technique performed manually by heating the reaction component to the DNA melting temperature, example is 95 degrees centigrade, before adding the polymerase. Touchdown PCR. In this type of PCR, the annealing temperature is gradually decreased in the later cycle. The annealing temperature in the early cycle is usually 3 to 5 degrees centigrade above the standard TM of the primer used, while in the later cycle, it is similar, it will be below the TM of the primer which is used. The initial higher annealing temperature lead to greater specificity for the primer binding, while the lower temperature permit more efficient amplification of the DNA at the end of the reaction. Assembly PCR. Assembly PCR is also known as polymerase cycling assembly or PCA. In this type of PCR, synthesis of a long DNA structure can be performing a PCR on a pool of long oligonucleotide with a short overlapping segment to assemble two or more pieces of the DNA into a one piece. It involves initial PCR with a primer that have an overlapping overlap and a second PCR using the product as a template that generate a final full length product. This technique may be substitute for ligation based assembly. Colony PCR. The bacterial colonies are screened directly by PCR. For example, the screen for correct DNA vector construct, colony are sampled with a sterile pipette and a small quantity of the PCR transferred to the PCR mix. Methylation specific PCR. It is used to identify pattern of DNA methylation at cytosine guanosine island in genomic DNA. CpG islands are concerned in regulation of gene expression in mammalian cells. The target DNA is first treated with sodium bisulfide, which convert the methylated cytosine base into uracil, which convert unmethylated cytosine base into uracil, which is complementary to adenosine in PCR primer. Two amplifications are then carried out on the bisulfite treated DNA. One primer set annealed to DNA with the cytosine, which is corresponded to methylated cytosine, and another set annealed to the DNA with uracil, which corresponds to unmethylated cytosine. Then this methylated specific PCR, which is also called as MSP, is used in quantitative PCR, provides information about quantitative methylation state of the given GSP islands. LAMP assay or loop mediated thermal amplification. It is modified type of PCR using 3:6 primer set. One of them is a loop like primer. This test uses BST polymerase enzyme. BST polymerase means Bacillus stereothermophilus DNA polymerase. Using two temperature, one is 63 degree centigrade for 45 minutes and another one is 85 degree centigrade for 5 minutes, may be carried out in water bath. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.